Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon from Jakarta, Indonesia. My name is Auki Pratama. I am the Executive Director of the ASEAN Federation of Accountants, or AFA. Now, on behalf of our host, the Institute of Chartered Accountants in England and Wales, ICAEW, Ikatan Akuntan Indonesia, or the Institute of Indonesia Chartered Accountants, IAI, and AFA, I would like to welcome you to the ICAEW IAI AFA Webinar Series 2020. Now, today's webinar is the second virtual collaboration between the three professional accountancy organizations, part of our webinar series for 2020. Earlier this year, in May, we have successfully conducted our first joint webinar focusing on financial reporting implications of COVID-19. More than 1,000 participants from around the region logged into the two-hour session. Today, we are expecting close to 500 participants joining us for this webinar. Well, ladies and gentlemen, before we start, today we are excited to presenting you with our two-hour program focusing on IFRS 17 insurance contracts. Now, we are honored to have with us a panel of global experts on the topic. We will share their insights and hopefully respond to your questions later. Now, I would like to invite you to observe the following housekeeping rules to ensure the effectiveness of our webinar today. Now, to enjoy the full experience, we recommend accessing this webinar from your desktop or laptop. And during the webinar, you may set your video to full screen by clicking on the square button on the lower right-hand corner of your video display screen. Throughout the webinar, you may post your questions on our slido.com platform. Now, by typing the event code, which is A176. So I repeat, A176. Now, alternatively, you may scan the QR code that will be made available on screen later. Our facilitator today will curate these questions and discuss them with the panelists during the Q&A session. Now, in addition to the Q&A, you can also access our short survey in slido.com. I would definitely encourage you to have a look at them and provide us with your feedback. Now, should you run into technical difficulties, please email our team, as you can see on screen now. Our team shall assist you to resolve any issues that you may have in joining this webinar. And finally, I would like to kindly remind you that this webinar is being recorded. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you may refer to the rundown on your screen right now to get a glimpse of our program for today. Together with our distinguished speaker, panelists, and facilitator, we look forward to presenting an informative and hopefully thought-provoking session to the comfort of your own home. And do not forget, you are also playing an important role in this session, so you are kindly encouraged to participate in the discussion by submitting your questions or voting any previously submitted questions that you find interesting. Now, to start the session, let me invite Mr. Mark Billington, ICAEW Regional Director for Greater China and Southeast Asia, to provide his welcoming remarks on behalf of ICAEW. Mark?
Thank you, Oki. I'm delighted to welcome everyone to today's webinar as part of our ongoing ICAEW IAEAFA webinar series 2020. And first of all, I must thank the Indonesian Institute of Chartered Accountants, IAI, and the ASEAN Federation of Accountants and yourself, AFA, as our organising partners who have played an important part in making this event happen. I also want to thank our panel, all ICAEW Chartered Accountants, for their support, namely Susanna Scheff, our Financial Services Faculty, ICAEW, based in the UK, Nick Holder, Chief Financial Officer, Prudential Indonesia, and Sandra Zhao, Head of Branch, Management and Tax at Cities Prudential Life Insurance, China. And of course, my thanks also to today's moderator, Alexander Tansil, member of the implementation team of Indonesia's Financial Accounting Standards, or TISAC, from IAI. ICAEW is a world-leading professional membership body, originally created in the UK by Royal Charter in 1880. ICAEW promotes, develops, and supports more than 184,000 chartered accountants and students in more than 150 countries. Our members advise millions of businesses, and over 6,000 organisations worldwide train ACA students. So at ICAEW, we provide qualifications and professional development. We share our knowledge, insight and technical expertise, and we protect the quality and integrity of the accountancy and finance profession in our efforts to achieve our vision of a world of strong economies. It leaves me to thank you, the audience, for attending our joint webinar, members of the three bodies, AFA, EIE, ICAW, guests from the Audit Board of the Republic of Indonesia, the Ministry of Finance Indonesia, the Financial Services Authority Indonesia, or OJK, employers, educators, faculty members. And finally, before we start, a quick plug for our next regional event, ICAW SME webinar series, The Impact of COVID-19 on Financial Reporting, taking place on the 7th of July. And those who are interested, please do contact your local ICAW office or book on icaw.com. Thank you, Oki.
Thank you, Mark. We are honored to have you and ICAW as our distinguished partner in the region. Next, I would like to invite Bapak Edward Tanujaya, EIE Director of Membership and Partnership Services, to provide his remarks on behalf of EIE. Pak Edward.
Thank you, Pak Oki. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, participants of today ICAW, EIE AFA Webinar Series 2020. As Pak Oki has mentioned earlier, this is the second time that we have this joint webinar. And especially for today, we have a very interesting topics about understanding IFRS 17. First of all, beforehand, on behalf of II, I would like to extend our greatest appreciations to our partners. One is ICAW, today represented by my friends Mark Billington. Thank you, Mark, for the support and the collaboration that we have so far. And both institute, ICAW and IAI, is a member of Chartered Accountants Worldwide, and hopefully we can conduct more joint activities in the near future. Also, I'd like to thanks to AFA, represented by Pak Oki Pratama as Executive Director here, whom IAI also a founding member of this important regional accounting profession organizations, and I think AFA has a very important international positions, as I know that earlier it becomes a partner of IFAC. And then I also like to thank to our speakers and facilitators, Ms. Susana Schiff, Nick Holders, and Sandra Sao. I think they all three are members of ICAW. And also to our facilitators, Pak Alexander Tansils, a member of implementation team of SHK or TISAC EIE. Well, it is a pity that we meet here today through online platform. Hopefully, after the pandemic COVID-19 is over, we can conduct face-to-face discussions of other important topics with all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, I think IFRS 17 is very important and challenging topics for everyone, especially those in insurance industry. Desak IAI is in the process to adopt IFRS 17 to be a new accounting standard in Indonesia as PESAK 74. There are many things that we need to know about how the PESAK 74 or IFRS 17 will impact the industry. And I hope that today's discussions, today's webinar, will give us an enlightenment on how the implementations, the impact toward the industry, and then how in Indonesia we can learn together from each other. Without further ado, I wish you all have a fruitful webinar, fruitful discussions, and I hope that we can meet again in another webinar series together with ICAW and AFA on other important and interesting topics. Thank you and good afternoon.
Thank you, Pak Edward. We truly hope your members and accountants in Indonesia in general will find our webinar today useful. Now, ladies and gentlemen, sharing the same positive messages that my colleagues Mark and Edward have mentioned in their remarks, AFA is committed to continue our cooperation and collaboration with professional accountancy organizations, partners, and stakeholders in providing ASEAN accountants, you, with access to the latest professional development resources. Now, today's webinar is an example of how our collaboration can facilitate learning and sharing between accountants in the region. For AFA, it is a realization of our priorities for 2020-2023. particularly on supporting adoption and implementation of international standards in the ASEAN region, in this case, IFRS. Now, the unexpected circumstances that come with COVID-19 also driven us faster than expected in our collective efforts to leverage technology. I am sure many of you did not expect online meetings and learning through webinars are now becoming an integral part of our professional and also personal life. Now, together with our member organizations, particularly the accountancy bodies of the 10 ASEAN member states, we recognize the importance of IFRS as a global language, not only for financial reporting, but also business and economy. IFRS standards are widely adopted in most countries, including all 10 ASEAN countries, albeit to varying degree. Now, different countries are dealing with different set of challenges in their IFRS journey. As a regional body for the profession, we prioritize on the common challenges that ASEAN countries are facing through sharing such as today. Now, IFRS 17 is not an easy standard by any means. This and the fact that majority of us may not have the expertise or familiarity with the insurance industry further elevate the need for ASEAN accountants to sit together and learn from the best. Hopefully, after today's webinar, we will have a better understanding of particularly the implementation challenges of IFRS 17 and what we need to do to be better prepared in implementation of the standard. Now, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce our facilitator for today, Bapak Alexander Tansil. Now, Pak Alex is a member of the implementation team of Indonesian Financial Accounting Standards of the Institute of Indonesia Chartered Accountants, or Tim Implementasi SAKIAI. Pak Alex will be leading and facilitating the presentations and discussion, as well as introducing our speaker and panelists for today. Now, without further ado, Pak Alex, over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Aoki Pratama. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Allow me to extend a warm welcome to all of you. Hope that we are always in good health and good condition. My name is Alexander Tansil, and I am a member of implementation team of Indonesia Financial Accounting Standard from Institute of Indonesia Chartered Accountants. And I am delighted to become a facilitator for this great event. Today, we are very fortunate to have been present with us the experts who have gone through the IFRS 17 implementation journey, and they would like to share their experience with us. We have Ms. Susana Skif. She is a financial services faculty from ICAEW. Then we have Mr. Nick Holder. He is a chief financial officer from Prudential Indonesia. And we have Ms. Sandra Sau. She is a head of branch management and tax from CITIC Prudential Life Insurance in China. Now we are entering the first session where we will listen to the presentation about the understanding of IFRS 17, highlight the issues, business implication, and also the industry alignment from the United Kingdom perspective. Before the presentation begins, I would like to introduce the presenter. Ms. Susana Skif is a technical manager in ICAEW, and she is responsible for faculty banking and insurance committees, which she leads their engagement in technical and policy works. This responding to the public consultation from the standard setters and also the regulators, and also running the events to engage the membership. She is a chartered accountant and she had experiences with banking and capital market audit and corporate treasury consulting. Without any further ado, I would like to welcome the speaker. Ms. Susana, the time is yours.